It's about two students at Loras. One of them is new because Loras has become co-ed. And so she's a lady joining Loras College. And it's a show about the two of them falling in love and supporting each other while their friends feel a little distance, and how that sort of shakes out over the course of a school semester. I knew that on occasion that this show would happen and that there was a lot of excitement and buzz around it. I know that the Striblings used to do this production, and the Striblings are characters in the show. And then Doug and Kyle continued the tradition, with Kyle writing original plays for the Loras faculty and staff. So it's been, I don't know how long it's been going on, but yeah, it's a bit of a tradition, and this is my first step into it. The script and plot have stayed basically the same. I've thrown in some action. That's been sort of my contribution, has been, I think these characters laugh on every exit. I think they have an evil laugh on every exit. Or I think it would be funny if this particular character was a know-it-all. We seem to have lines that suggest that this is a know-it-all character. So my sort of thumbprint comes through in the action, less in the dialogue. Very few things, did change a few things, very few things, because we like the script a lot. It's a really tight script. I worked a little bit with Kyle. We had some meetings about a year out just to talk about what kind of thing we wanted to do. And really, I just left it at, I think we need to do a stylized piece. And I think that maybe we could do a musical, because they had been doing melodramas for a little while. So I thought maybe a musical, which is still a stylized thing, might be fun and just a bit different. I don't even remember now. I know that we had our first table read of the penultimate draft of the script in May. I think we auditioned maybe in March or April. So it's been a while. And then after the auditions, Kyle and Stephanie would make another draft of the script, because we wanted to. A priority for us is making sure that everyone on faculty and staff that wants to be a part of it can be a part of it in a way that's significant, that they get to make their contribution, whatever that contribution is. I was surprised by how much fun it really is, because the script is so silly, because all the faculty and staff get to kind of unwind and just do something on campus that's ridiculous. So I would do it again just because it's a lot of fun. And for me, after my first year, I've been telling everyone, I finally get to see the faces of the people I've been emailing all year. So it's been really fun to meet people and see the human beings behind the names and titles that I've been electronically interacting with for a while. We have a little vignette of a scene in the locker room between Coach Barry and Nina. That was a lot of fun to, we sort of actor coached that one day, and that was a lot of fun. And none are coming to mind right now, but I'm sure there's just tons of times. There's a lot of times I say, wouldn't it be funny if, and we would just try something. Or things happen like Dr. Eby's shoes are off now, or Kyle pulls a rose out of his sleeve. So like there's just silly things that happen constantly that I really enjoy. That's funny because, so this is the first year Mike Gibson isn't doing the faculty staff show. But the story goes, if I'm understanding it correctly, Mike had difficulty learning lines. So this year, Mr. Walnut is, well, this year we have the character Mr. Walnut, but before there used to be a character in the previous trilogy called, I think, General Walnut or Major Walnut. And that was always played by Mike Gibson, and he always had basically one line that he would just repeat the whole show because he could remember it. So it looks like maybe that torch is passed on to Father Marr. So we'll have to see. My favorite line was one that we made up that happened, I think, on accident in rehearsal. And it was, the line used to be that Roy is not interested in women, he's interested in a woman. And that eventually became, it's not the women, it's all women. That's a line I enjoy quite a bit. There's a lot of fun characters because they're all just full of their own life. Yeah.